Okay, what we are going to do now, I think we should try to look at some of the tutorial problems, maybe two, three problems. And then we can see actually how everything goes on, and we can try to explore the partially constrained, improperly constrained, and properly constrained truss. Because what looks to us that particular aspect may be dropped, and we can just go through these simple exercises as a tutorial part, and then we will see that whether that can be taken into account. Since we have covered the method of joints, method of sections, and compound truss, so let us just try to go through these problems first. Okay, we go through the tutorial problems quickly. Just go through these few problems. Maybe we don't want to solve it completely. I just need some part answer. Let's say one member or two members. If we can just solve those, then we'll know that for sure everyone is in the same page.
Hello, sir.
Please tell compressive or tensile, okay?
MK tensile 100. LM compressive 80. LK tensile 120.
Sir, FMK.
LK is how much?
LK compressive 120.
Yeah, that is okay.
Sorry. Compressive 120.
And MK?
100. MK 100 tensile.
Compression, sir.
MK should be compressive.
FLM 80 tension.
Yes. Okay, so this is done, let's say. Everyone got it? I mean, is it okay? So shall we move to the next one? Just simple exercises we want to go through. Just give me the force in member BD, let's say. In fact, all of these can be solved. So what kind of, we can use the method of section. What kind of section is required? ABD, please tell tensile or compression. Tensile or compressive? It is tensile, so answer should be tensile 180. And how it is done? The section we have taken through BD, DE, and EG. If we take this section through BD, DB, and EG, then take the moment about E, right? So we take the moment about E by taking this section, BD, DE, and EG. So the answer should be FBD is 180 kilonewton tensile. Yes, so this is the section we are looking at. That's how the free body of this look like. Okay. So move to the next one. So again, just one quick aspect of it, the AD and AD, AE, these members are continuous, okay? There is no intersection. AD, AE, BF, and CF, all are continuous members. If we can get the force FAB at least, that is more than enough to solve this problem. Just get the force AB. That is just one of these forces. Get the reactions first, okay? Get the reactions first, because there is a roller and a hinge. So all the reactions can be solved in this problem. It's a statically determinate problem also, m plus r equals to 2n. Just take the equilibrium of the entire truss to find out the reactions at the supports. What is AY, by the way?
AY.
AY is 0, AX is 40 in this direction, right? AX, you have to show the direction also, okay, when you do that. It should be leftward. AX is 40 kilonewton leftward. And FY is equals to 70 kilonewton. Is that solved by everyone? Okay, so 70 kilonewton upward in FY, AY should be equals to 0 and AX should be equals to 40 kilonewton leftward, okay? Now we want to really find out the force in AB. So can we identify, you know, the basic trusses here, or rather simple truss? So can everyone identify that there are two trusses, simple trusses or basic truss? So we have A, D, E as a basic truss, and F, B, C as a basic truss. We need to take these two trusses out, and we have to show this, all the forces on those two trusses, okay? So draw the free body diagram of these two trusses, show all the forces.
Sir, FAB 70, sir?
FAB would be 0. FE is 70, very good, okay. So AB is equals to 0. So just draw the free body diagram of this particular simple truss, ADE, just draw the free body diagram. Take that truss out and draw the free body diagram. And remember, in that truss, what are the unknown forces I have? See, if I take this truss out, let's say I want to take this truss out, I already know the reactions. So only unknowns are FAB is one unknown, FDC is one unknown, and FEF should be another unknown, right? So there are three unknowns, and you can actually find all of these if we detach that simple truss ADE. I don't call it simple truss, but it's a basic truss now, okay? It's just a triangle, okay? Is that clear? Just detaching this truss, we have already solved for AX and AY, right? That was already solved at the beginning. So now once we do sum of force along X0, we should get FCD equals to 0 first of all. Then we take a moment about A to solve for FEF, and then we can take force along Y equals to 0 to solve for BA. So BA will be equals to 0. So there is a, should be here, this equation, there is an equation here. So this one is really coming from sum of force along Y equals to 0. After we solve these two. There is no section. It's a compound truss problem we discussed. See, now once these forces are solved, you can actually draw the, do the joint equilibrium to get the others, okay? So it can be combined also. The basic, you know, idea here is that we need to detach the simple trusses, get the unknowns exposed. And it is always true if you have two simple trusses, if the problem is statically determinant, then we should have six unknowns. Six unknowns should be exposed overall, okay? Is that clear, compound truss? Okay, so shall we move on to one more, but you know, the problem, this problem is going to be a little bit messy in the regard that it is going to be very complex geometry. But we don't necessarily have to solve all of these forces, let's say, but can we get the idea how to solve for the forces that are asked in the question, okay? Because as such, geometry would be a bit complex and it will take long time to solve. So we'll just try to understand the procedure, how to get the forces. Remember, there are two pins here. So ultimately, if you want to solve for the reactions from the global equilibrium, it's not possible. Okay, so we have to detach it again. So if I detach this truss, let's say, what is EY? once I detach these two truss, and let's say I'm asking that at the joint E, right, once I detach it, I have EX and UI that will be transferred to the other simple truss also. What is UI? What is the value of UI? You detach it first. So what is happening? I'm detaching it. Since it was connected by the pin, once I detach, I show it EX, UI, right? In one truss, in the other truss, it will be just reversed, okay? So what is that value UI I'm looking at? UI should be zero, why? It is a symmetric problem, right? See, that is a very important part here, because if we have to solve for the reactions, we have to detach this problem. By the way, can we get the force in CE? Can we get the force in CE? How do you solve it? Is it possible through method of section very quickly? Just a hint, using method of section, even I don't have to, you know, detach the truss as such, can I solve for FCE? That is a good method of section exercise actually.
Hello, sir.
Yes.
So FCE will be same as EX. So if you take moment about A, that will give you EX directly, and that will be equal to FCE.
So why FCE should be equals to EX?
That the line of action is same.
But there are two other members, right?
They are equally inclined.
So you can do the joint equilibrium here. The other way around.
Sir, you can, so one can even take the section.
What I am asking, let's say we don't find the EX even. Can I find CE?
Sir, we can even take the section along CD, CE, and KE, cutting those members.
That is what exact band.
Yeah,
yes.
Take
yes.
Moment about A, you'll get directly CE.
See, I really don't have to detach the truss if I want to solve for CE. See, I can really run a section through CD, CE, and KE. So just cut it. And then what do? We take the moment about A, because we can see that CD and KB, these two forces are passing through A. They will not contribute to the moment. So see, CE can be solved even, you know, getting into compound truss and do the procedure we follow, okay? So that is one clue. Even CE can now, let's say we solve for EX, from there also, if we try to detach the truss and solve for EX, we can get the equilibrium of this joint. But there will be three unknowns right here. And that will actually not solve the problem for CE in that way. Right? That one's because that will be only equal and opposite. So you have to go on the top. Maybe you solve for the D and then you come back. Okay. So the idea is that if you use the method of section, we can get the CE, but in order to get AK and KE, then we have to do something else, okay? So now you have to really look at what is your EX from EX. Once we detach this truss, let's say I detach this truss, then I can actually find what is AX, right? And AY, then we can come and do a joint equilibrium here to find what is AK. AB, right? AB is in the question or not? AB was not in the question. So KE, okay. So then we have to actually go to these joints individually. AK was there, yes. AK was there, no? So quickly, you know, CE is found, right? Just using the method of section, let's say we find the CE first. So that is found.
At E, we can find out horizontal reaction.
Yes.
Then draw the free body diagram of an entire left part.
Yes.
At A, hinge support is there, two reactions are there.
Yes.
So we can find out those support reactions.
That is
there.
That is what we have to do exactly.
Yes.
Okay.
And then take the section CD, CE, and KE.
No, but see CD, CE, and KE, that section, it is irrespective of, if I want to find out, let's say CE, right? It is irrespective of, you know, whether I get the reactions here or not. Just understand that part. If I want to get the member for CE, it is irrespective of whether I find the reactions here or not. Because what I am doing, I will just cut this, right, and take the moment about A.
Yes.
But if I want to find out KE, then
only
you
KE.
Have to go on that way.
Ah.
Okay. Right?
Yes.
Okay. So we now have to find out what is EX.
Yes.
And once we find the EX, then we can find what is AX.
Yes. And Y also.
Choose the
Y also.
Y also.
And then take the section and get the remaining also by applying conditions of
yes.
equilibrium.
So that's okay. That's the approach is.
Thank
okay.
you.
So the compound truss, as I said, that you know we have to detach the truss to in order for get this connection forces, those are very important. Remember UI will be zero. Okay. Just because of the symmetry. So we cut this and we get the EX can be found actually. Sum of moment about A, if you do EX can be found. EX will be 0.943 times L. Again, it's a very complex geometry is there. And from EX, I can find out horizontal. It is actually should be AX. Okay. So AX can be found out. Right? And then you can do whatever way you like it. I mean, you can do the joint equilibrium from one, or you can even do method of sections, because ultimately basic structure is solved. Because reactions are solved, that is very important. Okay? So that this problem was basically given, the purpose was that, okay, we have a compound truss, but maybe some members, you know, force can be solved, even I don't want to get into the compound truss issues.